Severe MMA, and we're standing alongside UFC welterweight Leon Rocky Edwards. And Leon, you know, everyone's asking Masvidal. Everyone's asking because we had the three-piece in the soda. But quite frankly, you're the fourth-ranked contender in the world, and surely the title shot is a better fight for you than Masvidal.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I believe so. My aim is to be a world champion. I came in the game to be a world champion, so my focus is on getting a rematch with Usman. So that's my planning. It will happen this year or early next year.
The fans are going to be screaming, well, why don't you get in there? And, you know, Masvidal makes sense. But does Masvidal make sense in terms of where you want to go? Maybe, you know, when you've got the belt, he can come knocking for a title shot if he deserves it.
Yeah, exactly. My focus is not on Masvidal. Like, so let's say London didn't happen, backstage didn't happen. I do not care about Masvidal, you understand? So my aim is to be a world champion, and I'm going to be a world champion, you know what I mean? So I'm more into getting a rematch with Usman, getting out that revenge, you know what I mean? That drives me every day, to go out there, beat the man to last beat me four or five years ago, and to go out there and defeat him for the world title. I think that will put more spirit to me to go and do that, you know what I mean? So, yeah.
Again, we've known you from day one, like, you know, right from the beginning of your career. You've never been one to talk a lot of shit or talk crap about people.
Nope.
You've let what you do in the cage speak for you. Now you're starting to get a little bit of love. Guys like Chael Sonnen are constantly talking about how good you are and how overlooked you are. Do you still feel that you're overlooked by the fans?
Sometimes, a little bit, sometimes. But like I said, I'm focused on winning. I go out there, I win, and that's what they can say everything they want to say, but they can't say I don't win. You know what I mean? I go out there, I win every time, and that's all I keep doing. I keep going out there, beating the so-called best in the world, and prove my case time and time again, and I'll be a world champion by next year, so I'm all good.
And everybody loves a winner.
Exactly. So I just keep winning, keep doing my thing, and we're all good.
You know, again, we've followed you for a number of years. That UFC title shot is in grasp now. Let's play the dream scenario. You get the rematch. Your hand is raised in victory. What kind of legacy do you want to create for that welterweight title?
I think for me, just a legacy for my hometown, for Birmingham, and to be able to be the first guy from where I'm from to do anything like that is, even this where I'm at the moment, I'm the first guy in Birmingham to ever get this level in mixed martial arts, you know what I mean? So I think that's more my drive, really, to show people from where I'm from that you can accomplish whatever you want to accomplish coming from where you come from, and my start, and now where I'm at the moment, you know what I mean? So that's my legacy, to show that you can achieve greatness coming from the bottom, and I'm proving it time and time again.
There was some talk that, oh, Diaz out, Masvidal out, Leon's in the background staying ready. Was there any truth to that rumor? Were you kind of keeping the weight down? Had they told you if one of these guys come out?
No, look.
Well, you know, I'm not going to be the hypocrite here, Leon.
I'm heavy at the moment, you know what I mean? I did offer, when the fight got made with Diaz and Masvidal, I offered the UFC that I would stay ready just in case anything like this happened, and they said, nah, it should be fine. You don't need to. So I kind of put my focus into December. So I asked them again, I'll say ready in case Usman or Kobe fall out. They still said no again this week. So I'm just aiming towards early next year, probably. Woodley be a good fight. Let's just see how the next two fights plan out with Masvidal Diaz and Usman Kobe. Let's see how that plan out first. Then I want the number one spot, if not the title shot.
March, London is usually that time of year when they come over this way. Are you looking for another, you know, another UK fight?
Yeah, 100%. It depends. It'll give me. Give me Woodley. Yeah, the talk is that it'd be in America. They said to me this week that they offered Woodley the fight in for January. I think the same day as Conor.
Mm-hmm.
Same card as Conor on the 14th, I think, in January. So they offered a fight for that fight, for the co-main. So I said, yeah, whatever. And
you know, that 14th of January, that means, you know, there ain't no turkey at Christmas this year. how worth it is that sacrifice going to be, though? You know, is that an easy sacrifice?
That's easy. Once I'm dialed in, I'm dialed in. I am very strict to myself. And it's weird with me, because I'm all the way in, I'm all the way out, you know what I mean? So when I'm all the way in training camp, nothing distracts me. I'm focused, and just find someone like Woodley as well. He's the number one ranked opponent, so he'd be good.
We've said it from day one as well. You know, we knew that there was something special in your future. I have no doubt that I'm talking to a future UFC champion.
Right.
But let's quickly, while we're at Cage Warriors, let's talk about a teammate, Jai Herbert.
Yeah.
Look, the rumor is really clear. Jai Herbert defends the Cage Warriors title, and this path has been laid before. he's UFC bound, surely. Yeah,
100%. In the gym, he works. You got to work hard, you know what I mean? And I'm with him day in, day out in the gym and seeing how hard he works and how much effort he puts into training, you know what I mean? So, I skill-wise, I think he belongs in the UFC right now. So, to go out there tonight, put on a good show, I think the UFC will be calling. To have three fighters from the same team, from Birmingham in the UFC, we're coming up.
Well, I got to say, that would make March just a joy for you guys, wouldn't it? All three of you on the...
Move back to Birmingham, that's the case. Me, Tom Joy. UFC Birmingham, right? They go London every year, so that'd be good.
And we have a they have done UFC Birmingham, you know,
back in the day.
Leon, it is always a pleasure catching up with you. Anyone you want to give a shout out to? Anyone you want to thank?
Not really. Just my team, my sponsors, my management team, and you guys for always being there from day one and from Fight UK, right?
Amen,
right?
Brother.
From a young age and to see my come up and. Hey. You stay loyal to me. You never talk shit about me in the media. So just thank you for doing a great job.
Yeah, we only do it behind your back when you can't. No, Leon, it has been a pleasure watching you get to where you are. And I can't wait to see the journey continue.
Good man. Thank you, bro.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.